Cape Cod has 559 miles of coastline, 365 ponds. Water defines us. Water is our big calling card. And that's the thing that we have to, as a community going forward, really protect and really understand.
Cape Cod's economy is integrally tied to the environment that we live in. So I think that's true of any economy, but I think it's especially true here.
It's the natural resources, and especially the water resources. We need to maintain that. If we lose that, we really lose the attractiveness of Cape Cod.
When President Kennedy was first elected in the 1960s, he really and truly put Cape Cod on the map. It had been a popular tourism destination before that, but we kind of hit a hyper mode in the 1960s, and our population just tended to grow every year after that until very recently.
It was fine to use the land, the ground, to treat and dispose of wastewater when it was sparsely populated and we had plenty of land and few people. Now with the same amount of land and probably 10 times more people, we can't use the groundwater, the ground, for that purpose anymore.
Wastewater is as local as you get. It's house by house. And at the same time, it's universal across the Cape and across these various towns. So this is an interesting challenge here, politically and environmentally.
Wastewater is the least sexy public policy issue you're ever going to deal with. Most people flush and they don't care what happens after that.
How we handle wastewater affects the environment. When you have the density of homes that we have now in the Cape and businesses, those nutrients start accumulating in concentrations that affect the ponds and estuaries.
Eutrophication is really a simple process of just putting too many nutrients into a system and then having it have certain species that grow out of control. And so what we have happen in the bays is we have certain species of algae that grow out of control, and so they gobble up all of the oxygen that's available. So there's no oxygen left for shellfish or finfish, and so they become an ecosystem that's dominated by one or two kinds of species. And so the diversity's gone. And once the diversity's gone from any ecosystem, it begins to die. And so when you look out on a sunny day, it still looks beautiful. But as soon as you get under the water there, you realize that that ecosystem's been destroyed. Cape's biggest challenge is the balancing issue. It's balancing the Cape economy and the Cape environment on this fragile peninsula. The wastewater is really the biggest issue that we're dealing with right now that tends to tilt that in one direction or another.
I find Cape Cod a very special place just because of the uniqueness of its geographic nature. It's completely surrounded by water. It's completely surrounded by fragile beaches, fragile ponds. It's a place that can see impact very quickly if it's negative, and it can turn around very quickly if it's cleaned up.